So unbelievable.
Sorry for the technical difficulties.
No, you're fine.
No, our dog pissed all over our computer. It's our lives. So, the ghosts be outside. So, Dan and Eric, that's me in my office.
Yay, $1,000.
Shh, everyone, shut up.
My beautiful fiance. Woohoo! So it's kind of funny. Becca's not my business partner. She works as a nurse. So I had to kind of get her here, use my salesman techniques to get her here. So I said, hey, in April, you want to go on a vacation out west? She's like,
yeah.
She's like, you live in Wisconsin. And then it was kind of one of these situations. So he's going to go to Disneyland. He's excited to go to Disneyland.
Are you saying that we're like going to Disneyland?
No, and also, I'm addicted to making fun of her, so we are the pride and joy of
ours only. Ours.
Just kidding. But no, for real though, we really do live on a goat farm in Wisconsin. Here's some of my goats in action.
Do you have 19 goats?
Is that really? That's really.
Yeah. Miles is
looking
at.
Okay, you need to get some.
We'll give it like 3 seconds.
Is there a video?
There's videos. Oof.
Do you need help, Miles?
Do you have the videos on the hard drive?
I got them on my computer and then the doctor.
Oh, there's no play button for them.
Yeah, they're loading. Okay, so I'll have to just post them to the group. Alright. The cool thing though is they love car rides. They're actually way better behaved in the car than my dogs are, for real. So they loved it. It's weird. Here's the coolest part though. The ROI on goats in terms of using them as a marketing tool is through the roof. You feed them, water them, that's it. And then you take pictures with them and people go crazy. And here's what I mean. So if you see ads like this that say goat farm discovers, whoa. Just don't look down. That's me. So
everybody needs a goat.
So, but seriously, I've done some cool things in my day. That's me speaking before Kiyosaki in Scottsdale. My partner and I are in the top 1% of Amazon sellers. I have my own info product businesses, which you guys probably have heard of by now. And also have a consulting business that I'm looking to kill. So a little bit about how I got into all this and to make sense of the nonsense. So I started years ago as a freelance copywriter. I was all over the place, working for a bunch of different clients, a bunch of different niches. The coolest niche I've ever worked for is dead rats. This guy would freeze dry and ship out dead rats to reptile owners, and I was like, dude, that's cool. So at the end of the day, I'm like, I gotta do something better. So I found this other guy who was selling on Amazon, and he was doing really well. He was doing $50,000 a month. And then I helped him out. I threw some copy secret tactics into it. And then we got him up to $3 million a month. And I'm like, dude, at that point, I'm like, this is it. Like, I need a laser target. I need to just focus on Amazon. Like, Amazon seller, working with them. I did that. Like, sky's the limit, right? So, fast forward about 5 years, working in the trenches, working my ass off, just doing all this for them. And then I got pretty good at it, right? So I had people just pounding at my door to work with me. And I jacked my prices up and up and up and up, just egregiously, right? So to this point now, where I charge $10,000 per Amazon listing to optimize it, and it takes me. I shouldn't say how long it takes me. But cool thing is, so I had too many people. Even though my prices are so egregious, more people want to work with me than there are time in the day. So that's when I thought, well, how do I scale myself? I should write a book that teaches them how to do it. And instead of selling it for what everybody else does, I sell it for what I feel is worth, right? And it's working. So, this is kind of cool. anybody here sell anything for 10,000 plus? I do. Okay, so if any of you want to, here's an easy way to do it. So there's basically two things I do when I offer to do $10,000. So first is I give them all of the, you know, 1/30 of the deliverables. But then I say, so there's basically like two problems with iTicket services. So the first is people are scared to death that they're going to give you money and then it's not going to work. And then, right? So what I do is I tell them, okay, you give me your 10 grand per listing. How many listings do I do? I don't care if you tell me. And then if you don't make more money than what I provide for you in the next 90 days, I'm going to give you all your money back. So right there, I've squashed pretty much every objection they could possibly have. And as long as you're not a shithead and you can deliver it, they're going to pay you all day long. Now, this is really cool, and that is it for evil. Aaron, I'm concerned. You might want to plug yours because you're such a nice person. So, So as an iTicket business consultant, so when I deliver this, the other problem is I don't want to refund them. Like, I don't want to refund them, right? So this is what I did. And again, please don't use it for evil. So one of my clients 2 weeks ago, I haven't told back of this yet. So 2 weeks ago, he gives me like, dumps me 20 grand or whatever, and I give him this spiel, all guaranteed or whatever. And like, getting to know him, I learned that he's a Jehovah's Witness. He's very passionate about what he does, and I love it. Like, you know, I'm part of the big C, right? So after he paid me the 20 grand, I said, Tim, I got a little surprise for you. This is before I did anything for him. I said, Tim, I'm going to take $1,000 of the 20 you gave me. I'm going to drive down to the Jehovah's Witness nearest chapel at Kingdom Hall. And I'm going to drop off a check for $1,000 to them on your behalf. Okay? And that was so inspiring for me because that enabled me to give to another cause who I would have never otherwise given to. Plus, it inspired him to know that I'm not a terrible guy. Because look what I just did for him and something he cares greatly about. And then the kingdom gets $1,000 that they would have never had from somebody that they didn't even spend any resources to indoctrinate or anything, right? But the cool part is, if Tim wants a refund, he's an asshole. $77 And guess what? paper. How'd it print out? Okay? And like 80% of people take the phone. So, and the other cool thing is, and then, okay. So the pump for this one, we have $400 templates, because this helps Amazon sellers to master their email back, their back end, which is like email follow-ups and all that stuff. So I teach them how to do it, and then I have the bump, or the actual templates that they can hack and then implement right away. And it's $400 bump. And about 50% of people take it. Now what are the templates? They're 12 pieces of paper, okay? So the ROI, the profit margins are not bad. This is like, when all said and done, it's like $1,700.50 for this plus the bumps, and it's literally two books and 13 pieces of paper. But there's value, okay? People buy it and they love it. Okay. Who wants to see a $2,500 book?
Oh.
It exists.
This one better be nice.
Who said? Okay, this one is nice. This is legit.
Wow.
Okay.
Hardcover.
It's heavy. It's heavy. I want to test this for weight. Don't die. Heavy, huh?
That feels
don't
good.
Open it though.
That feels
okay. Good. Okay. So high five. It's like 20 bucks a page. It's great. Okay. So here's one way I'm pulling this up. So that no, they're not available to Amazon. So these right here are my tripwire books. So these look like books. This is a little salesman for that. Okay? So what I call this is, sorry if I'm offensive, I call these my rabbit turds. So what I do, I walk in this, okay, and I get a con and you're like, oh my god. People find these and they're like, what's this? And it says on there, what does it say? So at the end, it ends on a major cliffhanger. Major cliffhanger.
Hold it out.
Yeah, that's it. So I'll get to all of that in a second, but I do have to, I have to get through some more stuff first. Okay. So I have to share, because I'm new, a little bit about how I got here. So I've been an entrepreneur my whole life. I won't bore you with all the details. I was a kid on the playground selling stuff for a quarter. And then in high school, I figured out that the stuff that you can wrap cattle's feet with, or horse's feet, if anybody knows, you can also wrap your cleats for the football player. And soon everybody's like, what the heck? That's the coolest thing ever. Because it protects the cleats and it's like swag, right? So long story short, I bought them from the place in Iowa that sells them to vets, and then for $1 a roll, and I sold them for $7 a roll. And yeah, so I got shut down in college because I was running a commercial enterprise out of my dorm. As a senior, I was in college, in class, making more money than the professor as a freelance copywriter. So I had senioritis to the max, man. And after college, every single year I tripled my business, year after year after year. But after a few years, I ran into an issue. I was doing copywriting for hire. I was making great money. I was doing like 15 grand a month as a kid. And I really liked writing. But I wanted to make more money, number one. I wanted to scale my business, and that's not possible. And I was already overdoing it, like I was trading time for dollars. I couldn't scale and multiply myself. I just felt really stuck and was getting burnt out. There weren't any software tools or outsources, like it didn't work for me. And then I was just like stretching myself way too thin, and I was getting really burnt out, and my relationships were suffering in a major way. I was, honest to God, I was terrified I'd have to get in jail. Right? So what I did, I bought a book called .com Secrets. Okay.
How much did you pay for that?
I didn't know what else I was doing. I'm like, Forward by Dan Kennedy, it's gotta be good, right? So I bought it, and I started reading it, and I realized, like, dude, I was doing I was wrong, and I planned, I came with a plan. start listening to Russell, doing it the right way. Probably a good idea. So, worst case scenario, my family's going to think I'm crazy to walk away from 15K a month business to go pursue something different. But I totally shifted my focus. I followed Russell's plan. That's when everything paid off. Okay? Get it? That's when everything paid off. And I had an afternoon that literally changed my life. So I went from making decent money for clients to making $207,461 in one afternoon. And yeah, thank you. So I sold over $200,000 of just one of my books in a single afternoon. So every single book box you see there represents. So geeked out, I'm like, yeah, it's the coolest thing. And then you know how like you go to the grocery store, you get a bunch of groceries, and you have to like shove the door shut. That's what it like was like, but I was shoving money. So it's really cool. But yeah, so I finally did it. Like I was getting out, like I thought I did it, and I made more money in that afternoon than the entire year prior. It's the coolest thing ever, right? But fortunately, on April 23rd of last year, my life got real. This isn't where the story ended. So everything was going really well. My business was booming. I had it all, I thought. But on April 23rd, a woman made a mistake. She made a bad decision. She decided to get behind the wheel of her SUV after having a little bit too much to drink on a Saturday night. She passed out while driving. She swerved across the highway into our lane, hit us head on at 70 miles an hour. "Oh my God, Bill!" I screamed. As the headlights came into our lane, then boom, just squealing tires, and like the banging sound of metal like crashing together, and the crunching sound, I'll never forget the crunching and the feeling of the glass coming over my face and my body, and then getting spun around like and hurled across the freeway like a runaway roller coaster that like you don't know if or when it's going to stop, and then silence, right? And then I looked over at my friend to see if he was alive. And that's the car we were in, but thank God everybody did survive. And as you can see, the impact was just tremendous. It ripped the door right off the hinge. It chipped away the steel rim like it was a potato chip. I ended up suffering like a mild traumatic brain injury, AKA severe concussion. I had 6 months of physical therapy, 3 months of counseling because the accident just so happened to be on my road a quarter mile from my house. Can't really avoid that area. It's kind of scary. My shoulder's still real jacked up from it. I missed a ton of work, and I was scared to death, honest to God, because I wondered if I'd ever be the same, number one. And then number two, how would I even know if I'm going to ever be the same? Because your brain is your gauge on if you're okay or not, right? And I worried so much about, like, is everything I work for going to just now be gone? And then finally one day, like, it just all made sense to me. Okay, still me, you take my life back, we'll just get through this, right? So I planned on picking up where I left off. Not just that, but I'm gonna double down on it. I'm gonna listen to Russell again, I'm gonna model after him. And I figured, like, I can't sit around anymore. Like, either I do this now or it's not gonna happen. My family's depending on me. So I reread .com Secrets, okay? Then I started listening to Marketing in Your Car, okay? It was by the grace of God. And maybe a Facebook pixel that John sent after me. But I went all in. I went big. I joined the Inner Circle. Went to Phone Hack and Lab in Dallas. I literally went all in. I went to imallin.com. And look what I got. $100 t-shirt. $100 I didn't Photoshop that. No, but really, Russell, he's the only person I think that could sell. I could sell $1,000 book, but he could sell a t-shirt and sticker and a tattoo for $300. So. But really, it's been the best fire run, the best decision I've ever made. It truly changed my life. Anybody else had their life changed by this guy? Yeah. So, this is the cool part though. So I left Funnel Hacking Lab with a mission. I was gonna do something I've never done before. I wanted to make $100,000 in 30 days. Okay, I'm like, dude, I'm so inspired. Tony Robbins, like, it was like a, I don't know what to say. It was so amazing. But I didn't make it. I did it in 13. She was driving a 95 Subaru Legacy with 350,000 miles on it. And I'll never forget one time she drove to my house and it sputtered and blanged and like died. And there was like steam and smoke pulling out of the hood. And she literally got out and ran. So I say that because what I was able to do for her is super special because that's something that like we've never had. So I guarantee it's not going to load. But this is the moment that I bought her her dream truck, I guess.
I saw a video.
So if y'all want to see it, it's like $200, but just search my name in the inner circle and it's on there. It's cool. Yeah, so that's our moment. And then I completely rebuilt my business. I've been a solo producer since 2011. Now I have a 25 square foot office that I bought. I've got 6 employees going on 10. Can't even hire fast enough to keep with the growth. Blah, blah, blah. Most importantly, I got my life back. I do believe that I'm here now because of you guys, so thank you. I really appreciate it. Now it's time for me to get back a little bit. Here's one. I got 3 secrets with no stack. Okay? So real quick. I know y'all are hungry. Hungry for success. Okay, how many of you guys have the most powerful salesman on planet Earth on your team right now? All of you.
Yeah.
The perfect webinar.
Yeah.
That's basically Russell in a box on the web, kind of. But no, seriously, that is the most powerful salesman on planet Earth. So I want to show you a little hack that we do. I call it webinar stacking. This is why I do it. So 80-20 principle. Jill, I think you brought it up initially. So 80% of our money, I don't know if you guys can all see this, Laura stepped on a rabbit here. 80% of our money comes from 20% of our people, okay? So what we look to do is grow our 80% by targeting our 20% as much as possible. So y'all have one of these. Oh, shoot, I'm gonna use all of these, bro, I'm sorry. Do y'all have one of these?
$400 a sheet.
$60 value. Okay, so here's the entry point for my $400 book, and there's a webinar there. Okay, cool. And then I have a $1,000 book that I only privately invite to the buyers of my first book. Okay, they get privately invited to the second, number 2. Perfect webinar. And guess what happens? It's only qualified buyers, right? Number 1. The other people in the world don't even know it exists. So it truly is private and exclusive. And the show up rates are through the roof. And the conversion rate is through the roof. And a whole bunch of other things that if you implement this, it's gonna blow you away. Okay? So and Bobby and Brian, you drank the Kool-Aid and done that, huh?
It works.
Yep.
Yeah.
Okay, real quick. And then we're talking about the traffic, okay? Cold, warm, hot. Now, one thing that I struggle with, and a lot of people I talk to, is how to speak to them. So there's basically 4 stages that they're gonna be in at all times. They don't know, okay? It's mostly them. So we talk to them. This is how you can practically, like in a practical way, know how to communicate to them at any given time in any way, okay? Facebook Live, emails, text, whatever you're gonna say. So those who are in stage 1, meaning they don't know anything about you, they're most motivated by fear, hope, and loss, okay? So the point is, if you're ever thinking, I don't know how to communicate with this person, you just think about which stage they're at. Where are they at, like, in terms of how, like, the traffic, and then where they are in the buying process, okay? So right here, like, fear, hope, loss, You're gonna reveal like an opportunity or hidden threat, right? And then number two, they're sold on the need, so they need what you have, right? So what's the best way to get them to do anything? Curiosity, okay? So if they've passed the point of, they don't even know they have the problem, but they know now they know they have the problem, so they're sold on the need that they have a problem, they're curious about the solution, okay? Number three, so this is probably still cold-ish audience. Now we're gonna get into the barn. The SOC is sold on the concept. Okay, so now they understand, they have the awareness that there is a problem. Now they're curious for this, they've been past the curiosity of the solution, but now they're curious about, they need to be validated. So it's ego, okay? And then number four, so that's warm traffic. Number four is SOB, sold on the brand. Okay, so urgency, scarcity. I would say that Russell Brunson's probably the best person on earth that uses that extremely well. So, for the sake of time, so webinar stacking, that's how I turned 200 people on webinar into 100 grand plus, right? Because they're already here, they've consumed one webinar, now they've purchased and consumed something, they've been blown away by the value, despite it looks like a little piece of crap book, it really is good. And then they get on the second webinar, and the conversion is just through the roof. So. A little bit about my goals. I really want to just be really do big things. So, as you can see, some things I'm really struggling with though are building a team. Like I think I'm in the middle of the three circles maybe, a little bit. So I know I need a team, and then I'm trying like heck to get rid of the hit by a bus syndrome, meaning like if I get hit by a bus, like my business needs to live on. So I need help building my team. So these are the areas that I'm currently looking to fulfill or I have already fulfilled. So right, like help me out here. Like, am I missing anything on this? Like I know a big key was to get a sales guy in there. I knew a big key, Boxing Russell, was to get an affiliate manager, which I just hired. I need an executive assistant now that I'm trying to fill because I need a gatekeeper. Is there a hole that anyone sees immediately or do you need more information?
I'm just scared to know when you would charge an event. Would it be like
an event?
Oh. Your book is like $1,000 to $10,000. So. Like, what would it cost for you to like what's your next up stuff?
So I'll say this.
You
said
webinars like it was $1,000, but what is there anything?
Yeah, so this
that?
Was yeah, oh yeah. So here's the $10,000 me providing a service for you.
Okay.
Which that's what the books kinda teach you to do.
That's
so it. I used to catch a lot of fish for people. And now I teach them how to fish with the books because that's more scalable. And then I have here, like, I just fired two of them. The last two, it feels so good. I had two $5,000 a month coaching clients. Mm-hmm. If I'm honest, like, I hate them. They're great people, but like, they just need stuff. Just, like, so, like, time for dollars, man. I'm officially done trading time for dollars. I'm done. So that's where I'm at. So I'm looking to build a team so that I can scale it from there.
Your folks obviously don't need customer support. The $10,000, is that just you, or do you have somebody else that kind of helps you fulfill that?
That's 100% me, and the problem is
it only takes time.
Yeah, but it's me. That's the thing. Is like I don't know that it's possible to catch someone up to speed to the point where they can do that in the time that I do.
Can you train someone to do?
I could do probably some of it, but still, I feel like I'm still stuck.
How much time? You said, does it take you like an hour, 2 hours?
It's embarrassing to say. Sorry if anybody has purchased this service before. It takes me about 2.5 hours.
So. Yeah.
Okay. But at the end of the day, I look at the opportunity cost of taking away from my business that I could be growing what I'm doing. Because look, I could freaking sell. I mean, I could sell 10 books, and I would spend zero time filling those, you know? Does that make sense?
Yeah, absolutely.
Yes.
Could you come up with a concept like funnel scripts? For your copy writing, so they just plug and play. Because then
that's
it's
kind of what
done once.
Yeah. This is kind of all inclusive, I guess, or like everything they need, but. So I feel like you might cannibalize it. Yeah, right.
Let's do a launch.
Okay.
That's it. You're looking for more, it's not going to be price, just getting more people to buy the product and getting to the website.
Yeah, so.
Yeah.
Yes, and I need to get out of the day-to-day crap. That's holding me back from that, I feel like.
The day-to-day on the right side of it, over here?
So the day-to-day is like I'm so tied to my business still. Like I just started in January building a team, and like they still need training. Like my sales guy just started, now my affiliate guy's just starting. I'm just so sucked into like the training aspect of it, and like, but I feel like, is that the right direction? I build it, I get that dealt with, and then I can be removed from it, and I can move on to bigger things.
You're always stuck somebody. It's like this huge slow back, right? Don't stop, and then you like figure things out, and then it like frees you. But yeah, first it's always like it's like negative. First, it's takes so much extra time at the beginning.
But is that the right direction? Because like I feel like I'm at that trade, like that fork in the road again, where it's like I'm walking away from this disgustingly good service for the whole like expectation that I'm gonna do bigger and better things than that. Like, it's scary.
How many clients are now do you have a month with 10K?
So this is just a one-time. So this is one time, and I'll do like 10,000 per listing for them, and I'll optimize it. And then at any given week, I probably have like, I choose to have probably between 3 and 5. And then this, I just, well, this was 5,000 a month. I just got it, because that was too much for me.
And someone else should go that 10K?
That, yeah, he kind of asked that. Yes, like most of it maybe. But still, like, I would like to be able to take a month away and do nothing in my business still.
Someone else do the 10K and like I don't do it for like a month to like, it might take you like 60 days, whatever. Like
yeah.
You said, the worst part about outsourcing is that first initial of having to train someone. But once you do it, it's awesome.
You might already have the guy. I mean, who bought both of your products and has killed it and isn't really doing anything with it but wants to come make 3K for listening.
Yeah, take a progression program for that. The most good copywriter is that's happening, right? Like Carlton can't hire him. If you hire him, just have the dudes write it and he looks like, oh yeah, and then send it back. Eventually that's what most copywriters do, is they scale as they build it. You just have to kind of finish the program pretty much through, and then they start putting all their copy to those guys and they just look at it. A lot of times the guys write it free experience for Carlton or whoever.
Okay. That makes sense. Now the other dilemma I have is like after I read Expert Secrets, I'm like, dude, I'm doing it all wrong again. So it looks great. I'm doing great from the outside looking in, but I'm really not doing well because like I don't have the attractor and all that stuff. And I want to do that, but I want to do it now in an evergreen market, an evergreen niche. I think that for me is copywriting, because like I go by the copywriting professor, but I'm not like owning that as copywriting in general. I'm stuck inside the Amazon niche. Does that make sense? So like that's where I'm trying to get rid of, pretty much kill off anything that's not automated, so I can jump into that new thing and own.
Is it copyright more though? I thought it was more like showing authors how to charge their books or work.
So yeah, so this is Amazon. This is specific for Amazon sellers. And then the new one is teaching authors how to sell books for high ticket prices.
Is that the market you want to be in, or the copyright?
I had that dilemma after I opened Expert Secrets. I realize now I think that the end game is to be in the copywriting business, and these need to be side businesses.
What do you love?
Copywriting.
Yeah.
Not to do it.
Copywriting.
I would say, yeah, copywriting, like, I was, like, that's a sexy business, how to like sell your book for $1,000. Copywriting is not sexy, we're mostly copywriting. That's my thoughts. I mean, you guys.
I agree.
Yeah. But like, if I became the number one or like one of the best living copywriters, which I feel like I could become, and then everybody's like trying to like names like Russell Brunson are like wanting me to speak at their events, that kind of thing. Like, I feel like I maybe could never get there if I stay in a niche. That's the dilemma I'm having.
Mm. There's a lot of famous copywriters. One dude knows they're sold a book for $1,000 to show other people. You know what I mean? Like, that's more interesting. I would think.
Okay.
I see, like, it's, I think it's hard to, like, look at Carl, all the guys that teach copywriting, like, never make that much money teaching copywriting. Like, it's like the hardest thing in the world to sell. It's like the, it's not a new opportunity. It's like, thing that sucks the worst. And another, and the copywriters, you do want to buy, like, the copywriters, so they're buying their first copywriting stuff, and it's like, I don't know, and that market never seems sexy to me. I mean, look at like Extra Secrets is my, it's like that's my contribution to copywriting. Like, that's playing the story. I never call it copywriting because like that's not that sexy. That's my personal thought.
Sure.
How many guys? How many guys right now would buy that book? Because you're curious.
I'm like dying to buy it. How much is it for? Like where right now?
It literally just came out, and the price I have is $2,500. I'm not looking to sell it to you all. So how about we make a deal, and I'll give you a copy for a video test only.
Man,
okay, all right.
Where's the camera?
Yeah.
Now I didn't bring a bunch. I really didn't try to sell, but.
But that's like such a unique thing. Nobody owns that. Super Blue Ocean, like here, and like it works for authors, works for any, like there's so many people it works for, anyone who's got any kind of talent at all. Like.
So my last two thoughts then, with that, number one, I'm scared to death of the author market because like my little babbles, they're broke. Like most authors are broke. And then
they stop selling a book for $1,000.
But they gotta
be still authors. You take somebody who has a course already,
converts
it into a book, and now they have another avenue to sell it. The same thing in a different medium.
Right. So anybody here that has a high ticket service, I feel like it might be better to take the angle of, well, okay, write a book that teaches how to do that service. Like the course does the same thing, kind of, but not really, because this is sexier. And then your downsell is the book, right? Because you can't hire me for $10,000. Can't afford that, that's cool. You can buy my book for $1,000 though and then learn how to do it, which is probably arguably more valuable. Right? So I could go after those with high ticket. I see the wheel spinning.
I think it's fascinating. It's cool.
So I could go after the people that have the high ticket services and then say, I have the best, most gangster down south you've ever seen.
Mm-hmm.
And then, do you think that's better than targeting authors though?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. A lot of them are
looking. Yeah.
Yeah. Business owners who basically got to buy the book or, like you said, have some course.
They have the content already.
Thank you, Dana.
Woo!
Welcome back to... Just kidding. All right. If I can do one thing, walk and talk, man. Always,